Let's see, I think this is going to be big enough to harvest. This is a parsnip that has overwintered. And yeah, there's a gut. It's got shoulders here. Not a monster. But we're in a spot here where I'm transitioning this bed to one of honeyberries. And I don't mind to have biennial like a parsnip in it, but when you dig it out, you're going to disturb the roots of the honeyberries. So this one has got to go because it's in between two honeyberries. There we go. And I also want to saturate the honeyberry area with asparagus. So this will probably be a good place to put asparagus. Oh, look at that. Oh, the mice must have ate that down. That's weird. Yeah, got plenty of stuff to eat in there. So since I'm here, I'm going to get some onions. These are spring onions. We're looking at the 6th of April. These are going to be onions for breakfast this morning, for lunch this morning. I'm going to leave a couple in here. This is plenty. So what I do is I just clean off the outer layers of the skins here. And then that's all fresh onion that I'm going to be able to eat. And right here we have more parsnips growing. This here was a hybrid, but these are heirlooms. I traded a fellow for seeds last year. And there's 1, 2, 3, 4 of them growing here. We're going to let them go to seed. 5. We're going to let these go to seed. So we're good. Look at that. What a nice harvest. And along with the honeyberries, I have already established asparagus. You see the asparagus plants right here and here. So it's heavily dominated by perennials, this bed now. And there'll be other plantings as well. I think some biennials for seed production, like these parsnips. But there are other biennials that'll grow tall that I can establish in here as well for growing seeds. One of them that comes to mind is skirret. I can plant skirret in here. I've got garlic in here as well. That's along there, there's garlic established. I never harvested them, so now each one of the cloves are sprouting. There's service berry along the end here, a couple apple trees, black raspberries, blackberries right here in amongst gooseberries and the honeyberry. There's an aronia in here. Yeah. Honeyberries, the berries themselves have a lot of potassium. They're not sweet, so they're very good for me, because I don't want to eat anything sweet. And this is a bush cherry here. This is, I think, a captivator gooseberry. You got honeyberry, and there's asparagus, honeyberry, asparagus, captivator gooseberry, honeyberry, asparagus. And there's a little honeyberry here. There's a little honeyberry right here. So this is like a carefree garden. Once it's set up and the bushes are shading the soil, then you don't have to really do anything after that other than pick. And that's what I'm interested in more than anything. I want to pick. I don't want to pay. I want to pick. There, that's a good theme. I don't pay for your food, or how can I say this? Pick instead of pay. That's it. Pick instead of pay. I'll make that as a headline.